Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Talking Fitchburg on this Monday, April 26, 2021. Hello, everybody. I'm Jeremy Crosby. Hope you had a wonderful weekend, a good work day as you tune in here for the evening. And wow, what a difference the weekend makes even to today as temperatures start to go on the rise. Very excited for that. Warm temperatures are here, and tomorrow we might even touch 80. Here, a lot of stuff to get to in the headlines. We'll talk about that here in just a second, including but not limited to. We'll be talking on the Fitchburg Historical Society's annual meeting that happened over the weekend. We'll take you out to that event, show you what happened at that virtual event. Plus, we have our Fact TV update as well. Tell you what's happening in the month of May right here on Fact TV. So excited when we're the guest and the host. It's all combined into one. Let's jump into the headlines here. And we start with this. Again, another week, another edition of thousands of vaccines available. Yeah, it says here from the Department of Health this morning, we got several thousand appointments for vaccines this week at the public health mdc.com and / appointment to book your appointment now. Walk up, bike up, drive up, free rides available the whole nine yards. No ID, no insurance needed. They'll be giving the Pfizer vaccine this week, which is authorized for ages 16 and 17 year olds as well. And evenings and weekend appointments are also available. So if you're looking and need to get your vaccine, you can do that at the Alliant Energy Center this week through the public health of Madison and Dane County. All right, McKee Road multi-use path will have a partial closure coming up here. I told about this morning. This multi-use path on the south side of McKee Road will be closed between Seminole Highway and Commerce Park Drive from April 27th to May 4th for asphalt repair. The Badger State Trail Bridge over McKee Road will also be closed during this time. Detour route during this period follows Seminole Highway and the path along the north side of McKee Road, and the project will proceed according to the following schedule here. And we've got it starting on the 27th, close the path and set up path detour signs, close the eastbound McKee outside lane for Commerce from Commerce Park to Seminole, then close the southbound Seminole outside lane from McKee to Seminole Center Court. Crews scheduled to mill and asphalt the path on Wednesday, April 28th, evaluate and mill the path, the conditions. Thursday, April 29th, crew schedules to have path scheduled to pave the path, and Monday, May 3rd, crews are scheduled to restore topsoil and seed along the path, and followed by May 4th, they'll plan to reopen up this piece here. And you can see here, follow the signage place for the alternative route, why this construction's going on. Please watch out for the bikers out there if you are driving around. And bikers, please be safe as you navigate around this construction project. Speaking of construction, short-term closure of U.S. Highway 12 and 18 eastbound ramp to northbound Fish Hatchery Road. This is continuing on with that flex lane work. We talked about it last Friday with Steve Tyson from Wisconsin DOT. This ramp, so it says here, the eastbound Madison Beltline ramp to northbound Fish Hatchery Road will be closed starting at 7 p.m. tonight until the evening of Monday, May 3rd. Motorists must use alternative local routes during this closure. The Beltline ramps at Todd Drive and the eastbound Beltline ramp to South Fish Hatchery Road will reopen on Monday night, tonight, and that's happening. So you know that that one's been closed for quite a while now, and that's going to be reopening. The ramp closure and work is operations are weather dependent and subject to change. So again, this is all part of the Flex Lane project, which is anticipated to open up late 2021 or early 2022. All right, it is grilling season, and we want to make sure that you stay safe when you grill. I love grilling. Can't wait to do some grilling tonight. May is just around the corner, and many people will be starting up their grills. With that in mind, the National Fire Protection Association, or NFPA, reminds us that July is the peak month for grilling fires, followed by May, June, and August. Let's stay safe as we grill our favorite foods here. And when we're talking about that, the peak month for all fires, that's 18%, including both structure, outdoor, and unclassified fires, followed by June at 15%, May at 13%, and August at 12%. You would really think May, well, I bet you May up here in Wisconsin's probably pretty high because you're coming off the winter and you just want to grill, 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 right? In 2024 and 2018, the average of 19,700 patients per year went to the emergency room because of injuries involving grills. Nearly half, that's 9,500 or 48% of the injuries were thermal burns, including both burns from fire and from the contact with a hot object. 5,200 thermal burns per year were caused by such contact or other non-fire events. Children under five account for the average of 2,000 or 39% of the contact type burns per year. Yeah, the kids are just fascinated with everything, right? Just want to touch everything. Gotta tell them no. These burns typically occur when someone, often a child, bumps into touch or fell on the grill or grill parts of the hot coals. Grills were involved in an average of 8,900 home fires per year, including 3,900 structure fires and 4,900 outdoor fires annually. And we've had a lot of brush fires this year, so you got to be really aware of your surrounding and where you set up that grill and what you're doing there. Leaks and breaks were primarily a problem with gas grills. 10% of grass grill structure fires, that's 22% of outside gas grill fires, were caused by leaks or breaks. You got to make sure you check all of the hoses, all that stuff, when you start up each and every year. You can use some water to put on the hose to see if it does spray out, or if you just smell any of that fumes coming from the fuel source, you got to be careful. Charcoal or solid fuel grills were also involved in 1,300 fires per year, including 600 structure fires and 600 outside fires annually. So all in all, we got to be safe, because grilling can lead to some very bad things if you don't keep an eye on it and make sure you're grilling in a safe space at the same time. So got to protect yourself in all ways. Speaking of protecting yourself, how about protecting all of your skin? Yeah, this graphic will help you do that. The sun's ultraviolet or UV rays can damage your skin in as little as 15 minutes. Did you know that? 15 minutes. Yeah, recommendations from the CDC to help protect yourself and your family are available online. And there's just a couple of them using the layered approach. Still the best way to protect, right? Layer up, folks. Sunscreen works the best when using shade or clothes, and it must be reapplied every 2 hours. And after swimming, sweating, or toweling off. Yeah, you got to do that. Wear a hat, sunglasses, and protective clothing to shield your skin. Use broad spectrum sunscreen with at least an SPF of 15 to protect exposed skin, and seek shade, especially during those midday hours when you can get burned really easily. Yeah, you got to do that and staying protected. And I do this ahead because tomorrow it's going to be so warm out there. So I want to make sure you protect yourself as we enjoy those nice temperatures. All right, that does it for our headlines. Coming up next, we open up the digest. We're going to be talking about this past weekend's Fitchburg Historical Society annual meeting. We'll have the details next right here on Talking Fitchburg.
We're all just trying to keep things running for those who rely on us. That's why we don't have time to be sick with the flu. And especially this year, no one has time to get sick. Get a flu shot for yourself and those around you too.
I may never have met you. We don't go way back. Maybe we wouldn't even be friends if we did. But when you wear a mask, you have my respect. Because your mask doesn't protect you. It protects me. I wear my mask to protect you. Mask up, America.
Gaining weight was easy. All I had to do was sit down and eat. Losing weight's a lot harder. I have to work at it every day. But with every step, I lower my risk for type 2 diabetes and heart disease. And that makes every step, every choice, every day very much worth the effort.
Learn how you can help stop diabetes by losing weight, eating healthy, and staying active. Visit checkupamerica.org or call 1-800-DIABETES.
you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg, transitioning to the digest. And today we're going to talk about the Fitchburg Historical Society annual meeting. It happened yesterday. If you had a chance to see it, we're glad you tuned in. If you missed it, we'll have it right here on Talking or on Fact TV. It's the second time today I've wanted to say Talking Fitchburg, Fact TV. But very excited. They had Ida Weinman in talking about her photography. And we want to give you just a taste of that great presentation. Take a look.
I'd like to, first of all, welcome everyone and tell you how fantastic it is to have everyone join this afternoon in our meeting via Zoom for the first time ever for the Fitchburg Historical Society. So we're making history this afternoon as we speak. Our speaker has been wonderful to be patient in several cancellations due to COVID of plans for having this meeting earlier. And but she's been just so persevering in being with us through it all. And today is the day we are finally able to bring you our program. So let me just tell you a little bit about Professor Herzog. Melanie Herzog is Professor Emerita of Art History at Edgewood College and Senior Lecturer in African American Studies at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. She holds an MFA in ceramics and a PhD in art history from the University of Wisconsin-Madison. She received the James R. Uderkofer Excellence in Undergraduate Teaching Award in 2006 and Edgewood College's Faculty Award for Excellence in Multicultural Education in 2008. With emphasis on race, ethnicity, gender, and cultural and geographic borders, Melanie teaches, publishes, and lectures widely on North American art and visual culture.
Thank you to Catherine Schneider and the Fitchburg Historical Society for inviting me to speak to you this afternoon about the photographs of Ida Weinman, who spent her last years living here in Wisconsin, in Madison, and then in Fitchburg until her passing in July of 2019. She moved here in 2006 to be closer to members of her family. Her daughter lives in Madison, and her granddaughter and great-grandsons live in Fitchburg. It didn't take long for the presence of this eminent photographer to be recognized in our community. In 2008, the Madison Museum of Contemporary Art presented an exhibition of her photographs called Individual Experience, the Photographs of Ida Weinman. And in 2014, the James Watrous Gallery of the Wisconsin Academy of Sciences, Arts, and Letters hosted a major exhibition of her work, Ida Weinman, Chords of Memory, in 2014. I will show you quite a few examples of her work today. To start with, here are two to give you an initial sense of the range of her documentation of human activities and emotions, the presence of people in these vignettes of life at mid-century for which she is best known. I met Ida sometime after seeing her 2008 exhibition at the Madison Museum of Contemporary Art, and I had the honor of working with her to select photographs for her Watrous Gallery exhibition, and I also had the honor of writing an essay for the catalog that accompanied this exhibition, and we became friends. I am deeply honored to speak to you today about her life and her photography. The hundreds of photographs she made depicting Americans from all walks of life place her among the ranks of leading American documentary photographers, a lineage that begins in the United States with photographers Jacob Riis and Lewis Hine. The late 19th century newspaper reporter and social reformer Jacob Riis dedicated his life to the elimination of slums and the improvement of building codes in New York City. Riis used photography, then a relatively novel tool, to bring attention to the plight of people living in the slums and tenements of New York City. Today, Riis is best known for his book, How the Other Half Lives, Studies Among the Tenements of New York, in which photographs made by Riis and other photographers document the squalid conditions of Lower East Side tenement houses. Riis is remembered as one of the first documentary photographers in the United States, but it was sociologist turned photographer Lewis Hine from Oshkosh who brought to documentary photography a deeply human empathy for the individuals he photographed, coupled with a finely attuned aesthetic sensibility. In Hine's work, as in Wyman's, we find the unique combination of, in the words of Mason Klein, a curator at the Jewish Museum of New York, realism and aesthetic presence that is so essential to documentary photography as we know it today. The photographs that Hine made for the National Child Labor Committee from 1908 until 1916 of children at work in mills, in mines, and on the farms and city streets of this country were instrumental in changing child labor laws, and his images of sweatshop workers aided the passage of work reform legislation. He later created a series of photographs that depicted men and women at work, emphasizing the importance and dignity of human beings in the process of industrial production. Near the end of his life, Hine said, "There were two things I wanted to do. I wanted to show the things that had to be corrected. I wanted to show the things that had to be appreciated." While Ida Wyman began as a maker of individual images, she, like Hine, came to conceive of her photojournalistic projects as picture stories, what are today called photo essays, rather than as individual images. And like Hine, she envisioned multiple photographs of a subject or situation as the most effective means to tell a story in pictures. But let's start at the beginning. Ida Wyman was born in 1926 in Malden, Massachusetts, the daughter of Jewish immigrants from Latvia in Eastern Europe. The family soon moved to New York, where her parents ran a small grocery store in the Bronx. In her memoir, part of which was published in her Chords of Memory, Watrous Gallery exhibition catalog, she described her family's store as the center of the childhood world she shared with her brother. And I'll read you a little bit of this description. "We took turns eating in the back of the store, a place crammed with unopened boxes of canned goods taking up most of the space. One small corner had a sink, an enamel-topped table, a two-burner gas stove, and one chair. If my brother and I wanted to eat at the same time, one of us had to sit on the cartons. Practically all of our meals, cooked on the two-burner, were eaten here since my mother worked almost the same long hours as my father. My mother prepared food with one eye on her stove and the other alert for customers."
All right, there you have it. Like I mentioned before, we'll be rebroadcasting the full annual meeting, so you can check that out here on Fact TV or through our video on demand. We're going to take a quick break. Coming up next, we're talking about Fact TV. What's coming up? The month of May. Yeah, it's already May. Can you believe it? That's next right here on Talking Fitchburg.
You could be spreading the coronavirus without realizing you have it. So follow guidance from authorities where you live and do your part. It's important to limit in-person interaction with anyone outside of your immediate household, but phone and video chat are safe ways to connect. It's also important to limit any social gathering. This advice applies to people of any age, including teens and younger adults. Visit coronavirus.gov for the latest information.
After you joined our family, it was like, I really do feel complete now.
Our hearts are made stronger by how we treat others.
Put her there.
The light you share can impact those around you, but so can the darkness.
Later, twerps!
Did Pete saying mean things bother
you? So when you reach out to another person, take a moment to consider how they will feel and let your heart be the key to making a difference. Because of you, someone's entire day, year, or even life can change.
In every heart, there's hope.
We're all just trying to keep things running for those who rely on us.
Ready!
That's why we don't have time to be sick with the flu. And especially this year, no one has time to get sick. Get a flu shot for yourself and those around you, too.
It takes all of us to slow the spread of the coronavirus. So follow guidance from authorities where you live and stay home unless absolutely necessary. Use a delivery service for essential items like food and medicine. If you must make essential trips, stay 6 feet apart from other people. Wear a cloth face covering and wash your hands for at least 20 seconds as often as possible. Visit coronavirus.gov for the latest information.
Well, Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg in the guest segment. And today, Fact TV is the guest. Hello, Fact TV. And I am Fact TV. So is Andrew. So is all of our great staff here. And we're ready to talk about what's happening in the month of May right here on Fact TV. We always start with sharing the media channel. And even before we get that, I'm going to put a special note in here about our emergency broadcast. We are coming pretty close to the end. So as things start to open up, tentatively, City Hall may be reopening up in May, as long as everything stays low as far as the numbers go, still following what Public Health and Madison-Dane County have, and of course, the state and federally what CDC is saying. So if all those things do come together, we'll be reopening, and that's when we'll stop our emergency broadcast. We're still going to continue to provide you all the information you need to know about COVID and any other emergency information. That's all done through here on Fact TV, but we'll change up kind of the structure of how we are running our community channel. So we appreciate you tuning in and staying engaged with us during COVID. And we want to keep doing that, keep providing you safety information. We do that here on Talking Fitchburg. All right, we start with the media channel, F1, where you're seeing this emergency broadcast as well. And here we share our community bulletin board. So I just pulled some of the recent ones I posted up on our carousel system. That's the media channel, we call it that. Everyone age 16 and older is now eligible for a COVID-19 vaccine. We're getting thousands of doses this week. It said at the time, this was dated on 4/6/21. And so they wanted to make sure appointments are available, and they are still available. Visit the vaccinate.wi.gov to sign up for the list and get yourself signed up as soon as possible, because they want to get everybody vaccinated as soon as possible. So there's been plenty of that. And then they were talking about some of the side effects, mild side effects and stuff. I had mild side effects when I got mine. Andrew had no side effects. Andrew's wife had side effects. My wife had side effects mild. My brother had them terribly. Like, everybody has it differently, right? So you got to be prepared for something. So just make sure you set some time off if you do go and get the vaccine. All right. Have an emergency rainy day fund. Andrew, do you have a weather radio yet? You never know when it may pour, Bamlet. Well, if you haven't put an emergency kit together, it's a really great thing to do. And I put one together last year for the first time. And I think it's something you need, something you should have ready to go. So if you need to leave quick, you can grab it and go. You know, it's got meds, it's got financial documents, you can put food, water. We had some water in there and things like that. So definitely want to check that out when you can. Or check it out when you can. Fill it in when you can and be ready for that possible rainy day. Sticking with the month of April, we had our severe weather awareness. And something that you do, you know, we spend a lot of years talking about, you know, when there is a tornado and road safety, what do you do and what don't you do? What you should do is get off the road is the best option, and go to a designated shelter, basement, or safe room if you can. Or the next best option is a small window or less room hallway on the lowest level floor of a sturdy building if you can make it there. What shouldn't you do? Well, there's a lot of X's here, so it's pretty easy to figure out. Do not seek refuge in a vehicle or outside or under an overpass. The under the overpass, what turns out to be, is a very strong wind tunnel. And yeah, that doesn't end well, and you can't get yourself high enough to avoid. Just don't do it. So don't park under an overpass. Certainly don't get out of the car and try to hide under the overpass. Not going to work out in your favor. All right, moving on. I've got a couple of city ones here. West Clayton Road is closed from South Sain Road to Highway 14. That project will continue now through June 1st. So make sure you are aware of that. It's closed the through traffic. Last week we had the full closure last week. So it's definitely important to know that that is going on, and got to be ready for it. So, yeah. Other than that, finally here, protecting our planet starts with you. That's right. Bike more, drive less, educate yourself. All great Earth Day ideas. Shop wisely, shop local. Choose sustainable over not sustainable. Don't send chemicals into our waterways. Do something to change how you can better keep our country safe and protected. All right, let's move on to our media channel, our community channel, F2, and we'll tell you what's coming up here the month of May on this channel. And as I continue, as I mentioned, the emergency broadcast should end this month. Talking Fitchburg continues Monday through Friday. We still have our Talking Fitchburg Rewind, the best of our interviews we replay throughout the day. Hispanic News will continue on as well. Local Perspective, Conversation Shop all have new episodes, and including D1 All-Stars as well has a new episode coming out here. On the other side of this, we've got a couple of sporting events to tell you about. We're continuing our coverage with the Verona Area School District in sports, including girls soccer and girls softball will be coming. We'll be doing a few games of those this upcoming as the school year ends. And of course, we'll have the Verona Area High School sports replay. We've been replaying all the sports we have covered so far. It's been a lot of fun. I want to point out UW Health. We're partnering with UW Health for their May Safety Month, and there'll be a couple of shows that are a part of this, from falls to gun safety, you name it, we're going to be talking about it. I got at least three shows lined up, and I'll keep the details to you as more comes out. And then the Fitchburg Historical Society annual meeting, you saw a piece of that. That'll be rebroadcast right here on our community channel. And the Gov channel, as it stands, still the same, same old stuff. And it's not old, it's new. Yeah, we broadcast all of our government meetings, and there is the short, long list we have for you. Still broadcasting those over on our Gov channel when they're live. We have it for you. Remember that you can watch Fact TV through here. You do not need to go to Zoom to watch a broadcast. We've been broadcasting and streaming all of our stuff since 2010. All right, that does it for our update. Make sure you check Fact TV for more information. Take a quick break. Wrap up the show next. You're watching TF.
Find good stuff at Goodwill and bring good home.
Opioid dependence can happen after just 5 days. Know the truth, spread the truth.
So how was work?
It was 1,300 hours. My math class from 302 was in the trenches. Davy Roth had it the worst. Fractions were coming at him left and right. He just didn't get the damn things. 2 days ago, I tried to teach him what 1/4 of 1/2 was using different sizes of blocks. Yesterday, I tried again by dividing up pizza. Both missions failed.
Oh no.
But today, I was ready. I created a combat math game where the only way to beat the enemy is to out-fraction them. Davey conquered every last denominator. My game was so successful, the principal is deploying it to math squadrons all over the school.
Anywho, how was your day?
Oh, today my boss treated the office to salad wraps.
Salad wraps.
I know.
Find good stuff at Goodwill and bring good home.
See on page 4 that the projections need to be blood. Next Thursday?
Seriously? Thursday? Can't do that.
This is really inconvenient.
I have yoga that day.
I have no time for this.
So?
I can't do Thursday, but I can do Friday.
Disasters? Don't plan ahead. You can. Talk to your loved ones about how you're going to be ready in an emergency. Don't wait. Communicate.
Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg, wrapping up the show for the day. And I'd like to thank Fact. No, I don't want to thank Fact TV. I do want to thank the Historical Society for partnering up with us to help broadcast out their event. All right. Remember to stay connected with Fact TV. We got all the resources out there. You just got to find and try it. Just try it. We'll be right back.